Hello friends, myself Amar. Now in this video I will discuss another Android library. Okay, here I will discuss swipe button. What is this pro swipe button? This is also a type of button. When this button will be swiped, then it will display a circular progress bar for your async operation. Okay, to use this swipe button in your Android project, you need to use this dependency in the build.gradle file. Okay, let me show you the demo first. Now as you can see here, this is a pro swipe button. Okay, now once this button is swiped, then it will display a circular progress bar, and if the operation is successful, then this will display this type of animation and it will display a tick mark. Okay, now how to use this, let me show you. First of all, in the build.gradle file, what I have done, I have used the dependency which I have mentioned in this text file. Okay, now after using this dependency, you need to sync your project by clicking on this icon. Okay, once the project is synchronized, then in your activity main file, what I have done, I have taken a relative layout, and then in the relative layout as a child, I have taken the linear layout, and I have used the attribute center in parent equals to true. Okay, now inside this linear layout, I have taken the pro swipe button having the ID as btn cart. Okay, and the width and height I have specified as match parent and wrap content. Okay, after that I have specified bg color, app bg color. This will be the background color of the button that I have taken as blue dark. Okay, what will be the text of the button that I have specified by using btn text, and the text of the button is add to cart. The radius of the button is 2. The text color of the button is white. The text size is 16 sp, and this is the arrow color. As you can see here, at the starting we are getting two arrows we are getting. What will be the color of those arrows, that you can specify by using this attribute. Okay, now in the main activity, what I have done, I have used the button pro swipe button, and after that by using the find vyd method, I have initialized the button btn cart. Now here it has a listener that is set on swipe listener that will work when the button will be swiped. Okay, now once the swipe is confirmed, then what I have done here, I have used a thread to perform a long running operation. Here you can use any type of async operation. Okay, and after that, here I have used btn cart dot show result icon is success true. Once the async operation is successful, then we need to use this method, show result icon method, and here we need to pass true. But suppose your async operation fails, at that time what we can do, instead of using this btn cart dot show result icon as true, what we can do is that here we can pass false. Okay, this means if the async operation is successful, then you need to use the method show result icon, and here you need to pass the boolean value as true. But if the async operation fails, then in the show result icon method we need to pass the boolean value as false. Okay, now let me run this and let me show you the changes. Let the project run. Just wait for a while. The app is installing. It's taking time. Now the activity is launched. Now we can see here, now again we are getting that pro button, and here you can see these are the arrows. Okay, now once the button is swiped here, now you can see the operation fails and the button again revert to its original state. Okay, so if the operation is successful, then in the show result icon method we need to pass true, and if the operation fails, then in the show result icon method we need to pass false. Okay, if you are passing false, then the button will revert to its original state such that you can swipe the button once again. Okay, that's it. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.